Hello, everyone, and welcome to the MathDBase.com Anicast Series. I'm your host, John Kisseadoo. This is the first in a sub-series of the Math You Need Anicasts, focusing on well-paying, unfilled jobs in vocations that don't require a college degree. Unfilled Jobs, Part 1, the Math You Need to Become an Elevator Mechanic. Recent reports indicate that there are over 3 million jobs that go unfilled in the U.S., primarily because people aren't applying for the jobs, or the people who are applying just aren't qualified. A large proportion of those unfilled jobs are in manufacturing, utilities, transportation, and trades, and all of those require learned skills, but no college degree. One trade with very good pay and a promising future is elevator mechanic. A person with elevator mechanic training, also referred to as an elevator installer and repairer, might install, maintain, and repair elevators, escalators, and moving walkways, as often found in airports, other lifts such as stair lifts in homes, chair lifts for skiing, and the kinds of hydraulic lifts used by car and truck mechanics. Though a college degree is not necessary to become an elevator mechanic, a high school diploma or an equivalent such as a GED is required. Completing high school, you will be expected to have a working knowledge of arithmetic and know how to apply basic algebraic and geometric techniques to practical problems. It would also be helpful to take courses in trigonometry, basic physics, mechanical drawing by hand and or CAD, and shop. To actually learn the trade as an elevator mechanic, you would have to obtain and complete a four-year apprenticeship through a union or a private contractor. During that training, you will learn math, blueprint reading, electrical and electronics theory, hydraulics, other topics in applied physics, and safety methods and protocols. In addition, an apprentice will receive thousands of hours of paid on-the-job training. For more information about apprenticeships, contact the U.S. Department of Labor, Employment and Training Administration. Some states require elevator mechanics to hold a license, obtained by passing an exam on electrical systems. Certification is also offered by some unions and associations to indicate competency and proficiency. For additional information about the requirements for certification, contact the National Association of Elevator Contractors, NAEC, or contact the International Union of Elevator Constructors, IUEC, if you just want more information about the field. Pay for elevator mechanics is a very large spread, with the lowest 10% making about $39,000 per year, and the highest 10% making over $110,000. The average pay is $74,000 per year. When compared with other trades, the median pay of elevator mechanics at $70,000 per year, the dividing line where half make less and half make more, is nearly twice that of all other occupations. Job prospects over the next decade are considered rosy, with an expected increased demand of 11% over the current numbers. Starting pay for an apprentice is typically between 30 and 50% of that of a fully trained mechanic, and the pay for an assistant mechanic, those who have only just completed their training, is usually about 80% of that of a journeyman, a fully trained and licensed and/or certified mechanic. Why not give it a try? Job satisfaction and pay will make your efforts worthwhile, and as long as there are tall buildings, there will be demand the world over.